Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Pittsburgh Pirates franchise series here in MLB 13 The Show. Season 1 ends here. The 2013 season will end one way or another today because it is Game 7 of the World Series between the Pittsburgh Pirates and the Toronto Blue Jays from PNC Park. One team will take home a trophy, one team will be just that close but no cigar.
For the final time here in this calendar year, we have baseball on the show, and they don't come any bigger than this. It's the big one, Game 7 of the World Series between the Toronto Blue Jays and the Pittsburgh Pirates. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskersian. Welcome to the World Series here on the show. With me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, everything to play for here as we get ready for Game 7.
Well, I think it's really been what you'd call a World Series for the ages. Back and forth, a lot of tight games, a very evenly played series. And now it's all come down to this. One game, nine innings for the World Championship, and this is what it's all about. Pull up a seat, grab some popcorn, but hang on for the ride.
Set for what should be a good one. Lineups and first pitch are next.
All right, so here we go, getting things underway. Dallas Braden on the mound is going to get a pop-up in foul territory. Jim Thome gets back there and makes a catch. Nice job by the veteran to get back there and make the play. So Dallas Braden's got a 1-2 count with one out, and he's got Melky Cabrera at the plate. He's going to take this ball deep, and it's going to clear the fence. Just like that, Toronto's got a run in the first on a Melky Cabrera solo shot. That's the way the Blue Jays want to start this road game here and get some momentum on their side, get Dallas Braden second-guessing himself in his pitches here. He left that one up, and Cabrera deposits it in the left field bleachers for a 1-0 Blue Jays lead. Can Braden settle down here? He's going to be on a very short leash. Remember, this is the last game. This is do or die. This is Game 7 of the World Series. We'll bring every pitcher out there if we need to. Starters, relievers, you name it. So we get out of the inning, and we got to take on Brandon Morrow. And he's 4-1 in the playoffs, and we've had our struggles against him. So we got to see if we can break through. McCutchen in the first inning. Nah, that's a weak grounder to second, and that's going to be a 1-2-3 inning for Brandon Morrow and the Blue Jays. So here we go with the top of the second, and that is lined hard down the line. By the time Willingham plays this, this is an easy double, and they're seeing the ball pretty good against Braden right now. That's not what we want to see. We get arms up in the bullpen already. We got nobody out, and that's Rajai Davis hitting one to center. Here comes the throw from McCutchen. He is going to get him to hold the third with the strong throw home. But we got runners at first and third and nobody out. That calls for a trip to the mound to talk strategy here to settle Dallas Braden down. He gets a 2-2 count here to his Turris, and he strikes him out on the pitch low in the dirt. Nice job by Russell Martin to hang on. They get a very important out right there. So Braden is able to get a strikeout when he really needs it. So up comes Morrow, the pitcher, with one out, and you'd like to strike him out too, but look at this, a little grounder to second, that's going to get the run home. He helps himself out with an RBI ground out right there. Great job by Morrow to get the bat on the ball. It's now 2-0. He gets the strikeout to get out of the inning before any more damage is done. But already we don't like this trend. Two innings, two runs, and you got Neil Walker not able to make contact there. Strike out, and we are on to the third. Here's Cabrera again. He homered. This one's just over the bag and fair. He's going to be rounding first and going for second. The throw by Willingham, not in time, and offline. He's safe at second base, and that is going to be the aforementioned quick hook for Dallas Braden. He's going to be done. They're seeing that ball too well, so he is going to be heading for an early shower here in Game 7, and we're going to call on rookie Garrett Cole to come in here and try to settle things down. Like I said, we'll shuttle in starters, relievers, any kind of patchwork pitching job we need to hold these guys down. That's strike three swinging for Jose Bautista. Nice job by the rookie Garrett Cole to come in and get that slugger out. So 1-1 count to Encarnacion, and that's a base hit to center. Runner coming around third and will score. It's now 3-0 Blue Jays. This is very troubling because everybody we've sent out to the mound so far has struggled to get these guys out. When their bats are rolling, this is a tough team to take down. There they're going to try to steal, and wow, that was not the best decision. Thrown out by Russell Martin, and they get out of the inning. So McCutchen looking to do some damage. Gets around on that one. That's a fair ball down the left field line. It'll bounce off the base of the fence. Melky Cabrera has a little trouble gathering himself, but he does throw this into third base ahead of McCutchen and holds him to a double. So now we got Josh Willingham already 0-for-1 looking for a clutch hit. It's going to be center. Is it going to be caught? The dive. No, we can't quite get it. And running on two outs was McCutchen. He will score easily on the play. But they get a little luck here with this ball falling in the center field. That's a great effort. As you see the replay here, it was hit hard and it could not come up with the catch. So a nice job there getting the RBI for Willingham. It's now a 3-1 ball game. On to the top of the fifth. And I believe that's Jose Reyes with a base hit. And he got runners at first and second on Gerrit Cole. That's going to be the end of his night. We call for Wandy Rodriguez out of the bullpen to come out here and try to get some outs. We'll see if he can settle this down as we've got runners at first and second. Nobody out. 0-1 count. Melky Cabrera. That's a ground ball and a double play ball. Let's see him turn it. Yes, they get two. So that's exactly what Rodriguez was looking for here. We stay with the lefty on Bautista because he's only hitting 200 against lefties. Kind of surprising, lefty-righty, but he hits this to short, and a good throw will get him. Playing the percentages actually works out for the Buccos here, so we go on to the sixth, and Tim Lincecum in the ballgame to pitch an inning or two. Well, that's his very first pitch, and that is out of here. Willingham cannot bring it back. Solo home run. That is exactly the opposite of what the Pirates were looking for, bringing Tim Lincecum in the ballgame. Oh, frustrating right there. But Encarnacion is not frustrated. He is feeling great after jacking this one out of the park. Another home run for the Blue Jays. And it is looking more and more like it is their night here. That puts us at 4-1. And Jonathan Sanchez entering the game. Like I said, we're going to shuttle him in here until we can find someone that shuts them down. Well, he inherits runners at first and second after that home run. And that's a base hit. Cannot get it there. Diving Neil Walker. Runner coming around. Do we have another run? Yep, that throws offline. And another run scores. It's now 5-1 Blue Jays. Things getting out of hand. Sanchez has to calm down here. 1-2 count. Two outs. Freezes Jose Reyes right there. And they do get out of the inning. But we need the bats to come alive. We got a 3-2 count. Starlin Castro facing Morrow. Oh, he almost went around with that really high pitch. But he says no. Ball four. On the appeal, so we got a runner on, and here comes Andrew McCutchen. We really need his bat right now. Had a nice solid hit the last time up, but he needs to come up with something big here. So as he settles in, and the hopes of the Pirates faithful rest on his shoulders. Oh, he hits this ball deep to left center, and it's a no-doubter. It's out of here. Two-run homer into the bullpen, and that's exactly what the Pirates needed to draw closer. It's now a 5-3 ball game on McCutchen's home run. PNC Park coming alive now. It's been pretty quiet here, pretty fearful of what was been going on here to this point, but this is a big development, putting the Pirates back in the ball game. You see the replay of this sweet swing here, and it flies on out into the bullpens as you see the relief pitchers scurrying out of the way there not to get hit by it. So 5-3 into the seventh now, and that is Jose Bautista. Well, guess what? Jonathan Sanchez just gave it right back. That's a solo homer, and it makes it a 6-3 ball game. Jonathan Sanchez, yeah, I don't know. He's just not feeling it right there. That's not good. As Bautista takes him deep, you see the track of the at-bat here. He could not find the strike zone early. Falls below 3-0. Throws a strike over, and then this pitch. Yep. Yeah, he takes it out of here. That's what happens when you fall behind to a hitter like Bautista. Enter Kyle Gibson into the ballgame. He's going to take his turn trying to slow down these Blue Jay bats. Let's see if he has any better luck. He better this game is going to be over. This one hit to right field. Aaron Hicks should be there, and he is, to make the catch and end the inning. So we need some more offense here. Pitcher's spot is up. Michael McHenry, he homered in Game 6. Can he do it again in Game 7 and be a hero here? Get his team closer. 1-1 count, and he lashes a base hit to left field. Falls just in front of Melky Cabrera. So no home run, but he is on base and does his job as a pinch hitter. This brings up the top of the order, and Aaron Hicks with two outs. That's a dribbler too short, and a nice play to throw to second for the third out. So nothing comes of that. We call on Tony Watson out of the bullpen to come out here and get some outs. Let's see if he can do that. 3-1 count, two outs, and that ball is hit to center field, right at McCutchen. So there we go. We get a 1-2-3 inning. Great job by Tony Watson. Probably the best inning we've had so far in this game. And Morrow finally comes out. Sergio Santos in the game, and that is good news for Pirates hitters. They have been struggling all night long, with the exception of the McCutchen homer. So there's a base hit for Starlin Castro. We got a runner on, and guess who's up again? It's Andrew McCutchen, 2-for-3, has that homer and a double. What can he do this time to add some more damage on? Let's see. He goes with this pitch the opposite way. It is in the gap. You've got a speedy runner coming around third. They're going to send him. Castro to the plate will score. It's now a 6-4 ball game. Another double for Andrew McCutchen, and he is coming through when his team needs it most. Okay, they've cut it to a 2-run lead. Let's watch the replay. Just goes with where that pitch was located and hits it hard the opposite way into the gap to the wall. By the time Bautista gets there, run scores from first. So McCutchen standing on second, but they got to get him home. And Michael Schwimmer will be in the ball game here to take over for Santos. That was not the outing they wanted out of him, as he surrenders two hits. Here is a shot hard at short. Oh boy, nice play there, and a great play by McCutchen to get back and not get doubled up. That would have been disaster. Jim Thome, base hit up the middle. Here comes McCutchen around third. He will score, and it's a 6-5 ball game. Okay, we are one run away. The rally is on. Jim Thome will be lifted for a pinch runner, as that is the tying run. They need speed there. Jose Tabata is out to run for him, and we've got a shot now. 6-5 ball game. Neil Walker is going to sky this high to right center field. That's not going to get it done. Two outs, and we have Russell Martin coming up. He's been a hero so many times this season. Can he do it now? That ball's hit deep to right center field. It's got some carry. It's going to be caught just in front of the warning track. So the rally in the eighth falls a run short. It is 6-5 now, and we will go on to the ninth inning. Who do we call from our bullpen? It is Jason Grilli, our closer. Yep, this is not a save opportunity. He really wishes it was, but he's down a run, and he's got to hold down this roster of Blue Jays hitters. He's already got a runner on first when Reyes is going to sneak a base hit out to right field. Runners at first and second, and an opportunity for insurance runs. Here is Bautista. That ball gets away from Russell Martin. Runners advance 90 feet, and they're now at second and third, both in scoring position. That's not good. They decide to intentionally walk Bautista here. Now the first base is open to create the force at any base. It means they can come home with it. Maybe they can turn the double play, get out of the inning. So here we go with Encarnacion. Hit hard to McDonald. Turn it. Oh, he bobbles it. He only has the play at first. He could have come home with it. He could have turned the double play possibly. But instead, the ball is bobbled. The hesitation there. And the run comes home. That is a huge play right there. Oh, we needed to turn two. We very least needed to come home with that and get the force. Brett Lowry swings at a pitch in the dirt and ends this inning. But the damage has been done. They got their insurance run. And it's now 7-5 with the Pirates' last chance coming up in the bottom of the ninth. They need to rally for two or this thing is over. John McDonald, who had the problem there, fielding the ball cleanly at third. He grounds out, one out. We only have one bench player remaining to pinch hit in the pitcher's slot, and that's Gabby Sanchez. So we will call on him right now. And he has had some success in this World Series, coming off the bench and being in the lineup. He's got two homers in the postseason. with 6 RBI. He had a 3-run homer in Toronto. Let's see what he can do here. And he gets a pitch to his liking. They're playing him fairly shallow. This ball's hit deep over Cabrera's head and over the wall. Solo homer, and this is still going. It's now a 7-6 ball game. How big is that play at third base with John McDonald not fielding it cleanly now? That could have been the tying shot right there, and instead it just pulls him within one at 7-6. Needless to say, it's not over yet. Just like the scoreboard says, they've got a shot now that Gabby Sanchez has gone deep. The crowd on their feet. They want the comeback here in the worst way. Let's watch the replay here on Sanchez's homer. 399 feet. Got out of here pretty quickly. A nice job in the pinch hitting situation. Our pinch hitters have been pretty clutch overall. So now you got Aaron Hicks in the top of the order. He hits this to center. And it's not going to have enough to get out of here, that's for sure. Handled, and that is the second out. We are down to the very last out. Oh, here we go. Starlin Castro will be coming to the plate. Hopefully he can come through with something big here and maybe tie the ball game. Let's see it. We've seen him homer in this series before.
Swing and a ground ball. This could do it. Taken there by his turret. And the championship trophy will move north of the border. The Blue Jays are world champions.
Well, let the celebrating begin. This is a World Series for the ages. And it came down to a Game 7, but all along, I really felt like this was the better team, and they proved it here. They are the world champions.
Back now on the show. It's all over, and you see the reactions there to the final out. And down on the field, we'll get a chance to watch the presentation of the Commissioner's Trophy to the new world champs.
Well, there it is. So close, but yet so far. We fall in Game 7 to the Toronto Blue Jays, 7-6. Despite a rally in the ninth, it is over. The Pirates have gone down in defeat. This one stings a bit. It's going to take a while to get over, but eventually we'll turn our focus towards 2014. We'll look at our offseason here and what we can do to strengthen this team, especially at third base. We're going to have to replace our first baseman, Jim Thome. I don't think he's going to be able to make another season. We've got decisions to make, so come on back as we try to put together a ball club for 2014. Oh, so close, but so far. Congrats to the Toronto Blue Jays. We'll see you next time.